Hi guys, my name is Ferdy and in this video I will show you everything I know about EverWebinar, an amazing software tool that will help you to put your webinar on autopilot. Let me show you what EverWebinar can do for you. With EverWebinar you can pre-record a webinar and show it whenever the visitor has time. So when it is 10:55 p.m., the visitor will see that the next webinar will start 11 o'clock. That creates excitement at the visitor because it seems that he is just in time for the webinar. With EverWebinar, you can simulate a live webinar by adding chat messages from other visitors, show how much visitors are attending, ask questions in the webinar, and when the attendee answers, you will get an email that you can answer. You can add polls and add links that will pop up at a specific time in the webinar. You can create urgency and scarcity by showing a countdown with the links, and after the countdown is over, the link will disappear. And EverWebinar enables you to configure high converting landing pages and optimize them by split testing so you can see what gives you the best conversions. It enables you to send automated emails to people who attended the webinar, who did not attend, who did leave early, who stayed until the end, etc. And of course, you can track data of the attendees with advanced analytics within EverWebinar. And last but not least, you can also integrate your own email provider with EverWebinar. And the great thing is I can give you an amazing deal through my link. I can give you EverWebinar for just $1 for the upcoming 60 days. And in those 60 days, you can see if you like it, you can put everything into practice what I show you in this tutorial. And if you don't like it, you can cancel your subscription and you lost just $1. Having said that, please like this video, subscribe for more upcoming videos and hit the bell icon so you get a notification when I upload a new video. And now let's get started. So in order to get EverWebinar, let's go to ferdycorp.com/EverWebinar. Hit enter and there we go. And I can get you 60 days for just $1. After that, we will pay the rest of the amount and within 30 days, you can cancel it. So there's no risk. Yes, there's a risk of $1. And I will show you in this tutorial how you can apply everything. So within 30 days, you should have your webinar up and running. You can make money with it already. And with that money, you can pay for the rest of the year. And if you really don't like it, you can cancel within 30 days. So if I scroll down a bit, I don't know if you recognize those people, but Jeff Walker, Frank Kern, this guy, Russell Branson. I don't know if you know these guys, but those are the top online marketers of the world. And they also make use of EverWebinar. There's this guy in the Netherlands and he uses this tool to promote his course that costs 997 euros. That's by the way, how I found out about this tool. And I bought his course and I was added to a Facebook group. And there I see that every day, 4 or 5 people introduce themselves as new members. That means that he earns between 3,000 and 7,000 euros per day using this amazing tool. So I want to tell you that this is an amazing tool and it can change your business. It's all on autopilot and I'm going to explain you step by step how everything works. So I scroll up all the way and then a little bit down and I click here on start my $1 trial. So if you get here through ferdycorp.com/EverWebinar, you don't pay more, but I get a commission. So thank you for that. I click here on start my $1 trial. As you see, we're not the first one that are going to use EverWebinar. There are 3 options: monthly, annual, and for 2 years. And the longer you do it, the more discount you get. So here you save nothing, here you save $100, and here you save $200. I go with annual. And again, you can cancel at any time within 30 days. And I click on choose this plan. Yes, for $1, and after that, $497 for 1 year. Continue. And I need to fill in some details. I scroll down a bit. I'm from the Netherlands, from South Holland. I click on continue and I can pay with credit card or with PayPal. Well, I prefer PayPal. So I say PayPal and I agree with the following billing terms. That means that after 60 days, they will charge me the rest of the money. I click on submit payment and I click on PayPal checkout. So we paid $1 and now we have full access to all the great features of EverWebinar. I get a welcome email, welcome account details, welcome to Webinar Jam, welcome to EverWebinar. Here's what's to do next. I scroll down and it says, you will be getting 5 emails from us today. There they are. 2 receipts, an email with access, an email for Webinar Genesis training, Webinar University, and a welcome to EverWebinar email. And here it says 30-day money back guarantee. So we need to go to our welcome email and then we can click over here to log in, or you can log in through your email. So here's my welcome email. I click over here. And then here is my username. And here is my password. And I click on sign in. I save my password. And I use EverWebinar. So over here, I click on access. I agree to all the terms and conditions, and I click on I agree. And it says welcome to EverWebinar, and we can watch this video, but I will also show you how to get started so you don't have to watch this video. So I close this. I want to dive right into creating a new webinar. So I click over here. And here we need to find a source of our evergreen webinar. And since it's an evergreen webinar, it means it needs to be pre-recorded. So if I click over here to configure it, I can use an external video or a previous Webinar Jam live session. So if you have Webinar Jam and you created a live webinar already, you can use that one. I use an external video file. And where's the URL of that file? Well, it can be an MP4 file, YouTube video, or a Vimeo video. And I like to do a YouTube video, so I go to youtube.com. I search for Ferdy Korpershoek Affiliate Marketing. Just click on it. And click on share and grab that link. And I paste it over here. And I forgot something. How long is the video? 29 minutes and 12 seconds. And that's important because you need to fill it in over here. 29 minutes and 12 seconds. Please enter the exact duration. Basic configuration. I click over here. The webinar name. How to make money through affiliate marketing. Webinar name, or you know what? I copy this one, I paste it over here. This one can only be affiliate marketing. I'm the only one that will see this, as it says, for your reference only, maximum 70 characters. I turn this off, I don't need that. Webinar description. In this webinar, I will show you how I make $700 per day through affiliate marketing and show you how you can start to make money online. The webinar language is English. You can change it here. And it is a webinar on demand. Yes, list it on the demand section. Don't list your webinar. I want to list it. So also other people can watch it over here. Webinars on demand. So all the people that have an Ever webinar account can also access it if they want to. Directory, category, internet marketing. Yes, that's it. Or finance and money. I think internet marketing is the best one. Okay. And then over here, I can add an image and it will be displayed at 284 by 206 pixels. So I have that over here. It needs to be below 1 megabyte. Like that. Webinar presenters. Well, we have only one at this moment, and it is Ferdy Korpershoek. I click over here, and then I click over here. And then I need to save it over here. And now you see it over here. You can add a second one or a third one. I click on confirm. Confirm by the basic options. I confirm it also over here, but it does not close. And I cannot confirm this because over here I still need to fill in 00, although it was an example. And now it says it's my own video. So I want to go to schedules, so I click on next. So here at schedules, I click on configure. And here's the webinar schedule. Well, the great thing is it's an automated evergreen webinar. So we can say that we want to start the webinar every 15 minutes and then people can attend. So at this moment it's 4 minutes past 4 p.m. So if someone would click on the button right now, it would say the next webinar is at 4:15. So in 9 minutes. And in that way they think, wow, I can attend a webinar within 9 minutes. Such a coincidence. Well, I want to be transparent to people. I don't want to lie to them and do as if it really is a live webinar. I think that's, I don't know, I don't feel right with doing that. So in the beginning of the webinar, I say this is pre-recorded because I will use a few animations that I need to edit, and it gives me more time to answer questions. So, and when people have a question during the webinar, which is all day long, because all day long people will watch your webinar if you have a lot of attendees, they get an email and you can answer that email and then they get a response. So that's how it works. So in order to do that, I can say over here, select the user's own time zone auto detection. So it sees automatically if someone's from Amsterdam or from London or from New York. Can people watch a replay? I rather do not do that because I think if they attend for a webinar, they should attend. So I do not enable it, but you can do that. And then they get an email afterwards because the software automatically sees if someone attends or not. And if they do not, they can get an email with, hey, you can watch a replay. I don't do it. Just in time schedule. I leave it at just in time because it says, hey, within a few minutes, you can watch the next webinar. So simulate real world practices, hide night schedules. So you can say from 11 p.m. until 7 a.m. you do not do those Skype calls, and then it looks like it is live because who on earth is going to do a webinar at 3 a.m. in the morning? But as I said, I just want to say in the beginning of the video that it is not live. So, but you know what? I will leave it as it is. So next available session is at every 15, 30, 45 or 60 minutes. I like 15. Display schedules, display the next three available schedules. I like to bring this to the next immediate available one. Then we can block out certain days, holidays for instance, and I don't do that because on holidays some people want to learn things through webinars. So I can block certain dates if I want to and add them, and they will pop up over here. Let's put 7 a.m. over here for the first webinar, and I want to edit. And you know what? I want to do one more thing. I want to turn this off. So the webinar will be available in every country every 15 minutes. I click on confirm and I click on next and I close this. So here at registration, we go to registration page and process. I open it. What you see over here is a few landing pages that will enable people to sign up for the webinar. So what we can do, we can scroll up, we can do split testing. So for A, we choose this one, and for B, we choose another one, and then we can see what works the best for our clients, which page does get the most signups, or we can select it based on the best converting one. So over here it says 30%. So if you take a look over here, open preview, this is how the page looks like. No distraction, no other links, no menu, and we can configure this. So I can have a text over here. Do you want to learn how to make money with affiliate marketing? In this video, I will show you how I make $700 per day. That's something you can do, and I rather use a video. And then you can change all this information. Let me see, I'm searching for one with a video. Let me see, where's one? Here's one with a video. So I click on customize. How to make money through affiliate marketing. I cannot edit this. This is all created already through our earlier configurations. And I click over here and you see a video. I want to have my own video. So I click here, video URL. And I need to use one from YouTube. So what the best thing I can do is upload a video on youtube.com and make it private or unlisted, upload video. And then here I say unlisted invitation webinar, a short video, and here's the link. And although it's not working yet, it will work in a few minutes. So I click on done over here, and here I paste it and I click on auto start. So right now it looks like this, but in a few minutes it will work. So then this will be the page people will see. So I go to actions and I click on save and exit. And now you see over here, this one is chosen. So I can confirm this and I can open it again And I can say I want to enable split testing. A is template 9. And then B, let me see, this one, customize. And over here, I paste the same video. Auto start, and there it is already. Save it, and here I change the text. I can remove it because I'm saying everything in the video. So I don't want to have too much distraction. I remove this and this. Just a video and a register area. I leave the colors as they are. Actions, save and exit. So now we have split testing. Make sure you enter 50 at B, depending on how much you want to split test. Otherwise, only landing page A will be shown 100% of the time. So now it will be shown 50-50. I confirm it. Form fields. And right now we have our first name and the email address, and that's normally what people use. And then we also can add the last name and the phone number. And if you have a phone number and you make it mandatory, it can be that you have less conversions because people are not willing to give their phone number to someone they do not know. So I don't use it, or I do not make it mandatory. And if you use it, you can also activate an SMS service where people get a text message saying, hey, the webinar is starting in a few minutes. Okay, so I confirm this. Charge to register to webinars. You can also let people charge if you have a really good subject. You're giving away a lot of information, then you can charge people. And then you can say how much. Link to the payment checkout. I will not go into this because I want it to be free. I click on confirm. And then the latest thing, we can make it protected with a password. Define one master password, so for everybody, or a unique password per person. I do not use this, so I say no password needed. I confirm it. Okay, let's go to notifications. I click on next. So webinar notifications before and after the webinar. I click over here. And if you have used at the registration the SMS, the phone number option, you can send text messages to people. I have not selected it, so I will use email. And then we have a few notification alerts and we can edit them. The first one is the registration. So when people sign up for the webinar, they get immediately this email with the confirmation and your webinar link. You can send it as a test email to yourself, or you can edit it. I want to edit it. Webinar confirmation, the title, everything between the hashtags is automated, so you don't have to change that. So here will be the title, affiliate marketing, Ferdy Korpershoek, a picture of myself, the date and the time. So you don't have to do anything with that. You can change the text over here. Go to the webinar. Congratulations. So we can change the text, or you can add a bonus to the people that attended the whole webinar, and you can do that with another email that will be sent after people have watched the whole webinar. Here's the link. There's no password, so I remove that. And then I can say cheers, 30. Title, description. So we can see here all the codes. So if you have a last name, we can place it over here. So we can also say congratulations, first name. And then their name will pop up over here. Okay, that's it. I save it, and I can also over here say, you know what, your webinar link and then first name, but I think it's too personal. The pre-webinar reminders. Well, I don't need that because people often go to the webinar within 15 minutes. Last minute reminder sent 15 minutes. No, I don't want to do that. So I close this one. Yes, I delete it. And here at live, post webinar messages, here is something amazing because if I add an email, I can send it 24 hours after they watched the webinar, and I can send it to certain groups of people, to everybody, to those who attended, to those who did not attend, to those who attend and ordered the product, to those who attended and did not order the product. So if you have a product you want to promote, they go to a thank you page when they bought the product, and you can put that thank you page into EverWebinar, and in that way EverWebinar can track if they bought the product or not. Those who attended the webinar but left before a certain time in the webinar, so you can say, hey, I saw that you were at the webinar, but you left early. Here's a bonus for you, or you can watch it again. You can be very specific with this. And the latest one, send this email to those who attended, stayed until minute X, but didn't purchase. Like, hey, you were interested, you watched the webinar, but you did not buy it. Why? Do you have a question? Here's a discount code on the same product. You can do whatever you want to do. And then you can fill in that email. So I do not do that. But you can. I click on confirm. I click on next. And now we can integrate with the autoresponder. I will not do this for now because I think the autoresponder of EverWebinar is great by itself. We can have an affiliate link into our webinar pages. So if you have one, you can paste it over here so that when other people join EverWebinar through your affiliate link that you have on your EverWebinar page, then you can make some money with it. Integrate third-party tracking system. So for instance, Google Analytics maybe, and there are instructions for that. Well, I will also skip that part. I click on next. And here we can customize our thank you page. People go to that page immediately after they have registered for your webinar. So you can edit it or choose one. I want to have one with a video again. So I click on customize. Congratulations, you have been registered. Well, first I remove this. No distractions over here. How to make money through affiliate marketing. When presenter, the webinar link. I can make another video saying thank you. We're just about to begin. Some very important information. So I can remove this, this, and this. And when they watch this video, I can tell them, put off your phone. It takes 30 minutes. I want your full attention and so you'll get the most out of it. So that's what I want to say. And then they can just wait. So I think this is perfect. I need to create a video for this. I will do that later. I go to actions, save and exit. Okay, confirm. Then survey your registrants. If I say yes, I can create a survey. What would you like to learn? But I don't do that. I don't want to overwhelm my visitors. Confirm. I click on next. So here are some settings for when the webinar is about to go live. Customize your countdown page. So when people come early, this is the page they will see. I click on customize. Title, the host, the date, and all this stuff. So when they're early, they see it takes about 3 minutes yet before we start. So I think this is perfect. If I click over here, not editable, save and exit, confirm, pre-configure your webinar polls. If I have polls, I could add them on this page. No. Live chat box. The chat is disabled. You can enable the chat and you can even fake it. Like John is saying, hey, how about this? And then in the video, you can say, hey, good question. And you can answer it, but that's only implying that you're doing this live and that's not the case. So I rather do not use this. You can also import it through a CSV file. So you can create everything in Excel and then import it. But I rather do not use it. You can do this one. That's the best option. People can ask a question and then an email will be sent to info@verdicorpushook.com or maybe better chat@verdicorpushook.com. Confirm. Then we have feedback flow announcements. That's kind of the same as a chat box. You can show messages from people that everybody that attends the webinar will see on a certain time, like, wow, this is amazing. And if you want to know more about all these options, you can click on the video help button. Product offer. We can add a new offer. And when should the offer start? Well, my video is in 29 minutes, so at 27, these are hours, 27 minutes and 0.3 seconds. And then I should keep in mind that I need to edit the video to align it perfectly. So I say, from now on, you see my offer here below. And imagine it will be minute 27 and second 3. And the offer is available for 5 minutes, 32.03. Name of the offer, affiliate marketing with Makem Spencer. or Spencer Meckham. I don't know how to pronounce his surname. Offer headlines. Become an affiliate pro. I should have an image. So let me see. I'll save this. And upload it. Start with a free webinar because he also starts with a webinar. Text inside of the button, go to Spencer. And then there's the button link. And then I need to get my affiliate link. Here's the link, https ferdycorp.com/Spencer in new tab. And at this moment it's free. Do I want to apply urgency, like for this long and it's available? You can do that. 5 minutes, 0 seconds, 0 hours. So also here I should say 0 and 0. Yes. Save it. Okay. Redirect to external websites. No, thank you. We can have sticky messages. Display number of attendees. Don't display or fixed attendees. Dynamic attendees. And this is all a little bit fake, so don't display it. Live sales alerts when people buy it. You can do that. I don't want to do that. Pre-configure file sharing. For instance, I can have a PDF with the top 10 best affiliate products to promote in 2019 and 2020. Well, I can add the PDF, upload the file, and I can say open it up at minute 29 because that's for all the people that are staying until the end for the bonus. And then this is the bonus and it stays until the 31st minute. 0000. Here I upload the PDF file. And then that way you can give people the bonus. I confirm it. I confirm this. And when everything is confirmed, I click on next. Enable webinar replay. I don't want that. So I confirm that it's not available. And I click on next. Congratulations, your webinar has been successfully created. So what is next? I go to my dashboard and I can share my page. So I go to the dashboard and over here I can get my links. So this link over here, I copy it and I paste it.
Hi guys, my name is Ferdy and I make a living through affiliate marketing. And in my webinar, I'm going to show you exactly how I make $700. Per day. If you want to know more about it, click on the link next to the video and I will show you how I make my money and how you can do the same. Yes, okay, have a great day and maybe I will see you in the webinar.
Okay, well, this is not something I like, so maybe I can make a long pause at the end of the video. So what I can do now, I go back to my webinars and over here, I go to your links. As I said, we can share this, but we can also embed it in our website. Maybe you use Elementor or ClickFunnels. So I select it. I go to my website. Edit with Elementor. So let me scroll down just in case. And I go for the text editor. I go to the text tab and I paste the code. And there it says register now, update, preview the changes. And if I click over here, I get an pop up like this. Thursday, 11 p.m. Yes. And then I can register. So that's the difference with the normal link, because if I would create a button over here, button, and I say register now, and I place the link over here, update, preview the changes. What the difference is that when you click here, you go to the page. And what I prefer is this one. So I could place it over here if I want to. So that's it. So what we can do now, we can grab this link, go to Facebook, for instance, to my page, and I can post something. And then you see the text over here, and then people can go to the webinar, or you paste it on your website. And what a lot of people do these days, they do Facebook advertisements to get people to their webinar page, this one, and then they sign up and they think, whoa, only 10 minutes left, oh, that's amazing, I'll sign up. And one more thing, I don't like the YouTube layout over here. So what I prefer to do is to upload a file to my website, for instance, FertiCorp. I go to the backend, to media, add new, select the file. And then this 30 megabyte file, I upload it. I click on it. I grab the link, copy, and I close this. I click on edit and then add registration. Let me see. I customize it. And over here, I click here. I paste this link. Auto start. Save it. And then you don't see all that stuff that you see with YouTube. Save and exit. Go to the other one, B. This one. And there I also paste this one. Save it. Save and exit. Confirm. Go to the next one. So now, when we take a look at the example, view links, copy link. Hi guys, my name is Freddy. This is much better. And of course, I need to remove this stuff over here and this and this and this. But that's how it works. I close everything. So I will put this online for a few days and then I will show you the analytics. So I have configured everything. Let me show you how things look. And he has a course where he will. This is how the layout is. How they can do it himself. He also has, I have a timer. If you want to watch that webinar, I don't know if it's live or if it's. I have no open chat, so I do not see chat messages of other people. And here at minute 30, you see the link popping up to the course of Spencer Mackam. It is an affiliate link. That's how this works. And I hope you'll learn a ton of stuff in this video. Thank you for attending this webinar. And I hope you have a great day. Bye-bye. So it's now a few days later. Let's take a look at the analytics of my webinar. And the analytics are also based on the quality of the webinar. I have to say this is not the best webinar. There are webinar scripts. If you want to know more about that, go to YouTube and search for the perfect webinar. And then it's this video, 1 hour, 50 minutes, where Russell Brunson will tell you more about the perfect webinar. And that will help you a lot to get more conversions. So I select the webinar. I have one, all sessions, all time. I click on go. And this is how the analytics look. The traffic. 75 people registered to my Facebook post and my YouTube post. 90 people signed up. And since it's a few minutes later, 14 people of those 90 people went to the live webinar. There are no replays because I did not turn it on. Then we have the split test, and what you see over here, version A is better than version B. So here is the sign up rate, 32%, and here 22. So I should get rid of this, make a copy of this one, copy it to B, and then change something slightly so I can see what will convert better. And in that way you can optimize it. And in the long run, this will help you a lot, especially when you're going to do Facebook ads. The conversion rate is so important. A few percentage can change the whole business for you. Inside the webinar, what happened? The live broadcast is 31 minutes. The average time in the room of people is 90 minutes. And there's no replay. Live in the webinar, peak 10 attendees in a short amount of time. And this is how it is. The most people only watched 5 minutes, a few 10, a few 15. And that's how it went. So my webinar is probably not that interesting. And I have to say that the people who saw this webinar saw my other video a few days before on YouTube. So I think they knew the story already. So I need to create a unique webinar because that will bring a lot more engagement and no replay statistics because there is none. The dropout rate. 21% drops out in the first 5 minutes, 21 after that, the second 5 minutes, and then it goes like that, and a few at the end. Wow, this is really late. And the offers clicked from live. I had one offer, affiliate marketing with Spencer Mackham, 4 clicks, and a user rating, 2 ratings of 4 stars. So I could do much better. Monetization. Well, there was no fee, so this is all zero, but there are some nice statistics over here. Notifications. The welcome message, the confirmation link which people get immediately after they register. 14 sent, 12 opened, and 7 clicked. Pre-webinar reminders, there are none because every webinar is within 15 minutes. Last minute reminder, I have none. And while the webinar was live, I had no message because there was no replay. So there are no statistics about that. And here I can see who did register. And then I can select it based on the session. Did not attend. So I could say everybody did not attend, export it, and then send them an email. But it's also automatic. We configured it before that when people do not attend, they get an email. And we can configure that email. Over here, my account. You can create a new password by typing it here and then typing it again because the password we got was automatically created. One more thing, if you click over here, you can join the group Ever Webinar. Yes. Affiliate marketing. Submit. And then you will be added to the group. And there are a few posts per day, and maybe you can learn something or ask questions if you have questions. So that's it. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you learned a ton of stuff. Feel free to like this video and to subscribe for more upcoming videos. And if you hit the bell icon, you get a notification when I upload a new video. Have a great day, and you will see me the next time. Bye bye.